I sometimes play stuff that I like, which doesn't mean it's great. It just means it motivates me to do more, which is great. That was some snip I randomly played on an electronic drum kit with, I think, 808 sounds selected. Roland 808, you should, if you don't know it, check it. One of the first drum computers that had sounds back then that are still in use today, like legacy kind of sounds, still in use in modern productions. And I played this because it sounded to me a little bit like Snoop Dogg, groove-ish, like weird, and maybe I play a snippet in. I have it on the backup drive, I think, somewhere, that idea from back then. I tried to emulate this on an acoustic drum kit, and what I was going for was, first of all, play a lot with a bass drum because I want to be able to do it. I like the sound. Secondly, random hi-hats that goes off in 16ths sometimes, but not always. And always this kind of two 16th notes closing a phrase. You know, and then you go into the next one, sort of as a lick. And I was just playing with this right now to find out where I could go with it. Should I loop it more tightly, like be more accurate with my repetition, or should I find maybe a bridge section for a potential composition? I don't know. It's fun to play on this kit with this groove because that drum is tuned really not so well, so it sounds really long. But I can dampen it with my hand, so I'm playing it long. I'm playing with the sustain, or just take it away by just brushing How do I do it? Yeah, with the back of my hand, I think I did it. I don't know. I have to watch my own video. I dampened it at some point. And then also, I try to, which is very hard for, I think, us drummers, not play a hi-hat on one or not play a crash on one. So you go dung dung, and then you just have the bass drum go. And I think that is something that producers have an advantage over us drum nerds, because we're kind of, not all of us, you know, don't get me wrong, all of us, there's a lot of very creative, advanced drummers out there that, you know, just untouched. But what I'm saying is, us, me, drummers, conventionally trained, conventionally coming from a conventional background, it's very hard to omit certain habits we have. And playing something with a hi-hat on one or with a cymbal on one is very habitual. I think we can agree on that. And to not do it just opens a different soundscape to me. It's interesting to try it, and then, you know, I'm motivated to do more. So that's kind of what keeps me, that's what keeps me motivated, I think, to go with a concept and then try to see where it leads me. And then I find maybe I lack technical abilities to really nail it, so I have something to practice. Or it opens up musical concepts that I haven't yet grasped, but I like. I notice I sometimes play stuff that I like, which doesn't mean it's great. It just means it motivates me to do more, which is great. Well, that's one kit. That's one cam. One man. One human. And that's it for today. On to the next one.